What's going on, guys? This is not your regular guy. No, this is your motivation guy. That's right. I'm here to motivate you, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. Make sure no matter what, man, continue to grind. Never give up, never surrender. I want you to be successful not only in this game, but also in life. Today, we're going to be discussing the recent Q&A hosted by Riot, including details about Peeker's Advantage, Strafe Shooting, Ranked, and Vanguard. But first, we have our question of the day. You guys ready for that? Here we go. How has Peeker's Advantage affected you in Valorant? Personally, you know, I feel like it almost got a bit worse after this most recent patch, 0.50. I've had quite a few people seemingly run one-tap me after the patch, so I'm quite interested in what Riot has to say in this Q&A. And guys, do not forget to leave your answer in the comments down below. You know, we do try to read all of them. We also just launched Valorant coaching on our website, ProGuides.com. We have actual Valorant pros just waiting to help you guys climb out of low elo. So make sure to sign up today before all of our pros are booked. All right, so starting off, let's give a quick background as to what Peeker's Advantage it is, right? In an online game, all the important data about your character, including what keys you're pressing on your keyboard or when you know you shoot your weapon, is sent to a server that then sends that same information to all the other players in your game. Okay, so this is how you see people moving, shooting, and performing actions in real time. Now, the speed of that information, you know, reaching the server is affected by a few things, but let's keep it simple and only talk about ping, all right? Ping is how long it takes your internet connection to send a message to the server, and how long it takes your computer to receive a message back from the server, right? But to make the game a bit more enjoyable for players with high ping, most online games try to predict the next movements of the player. You know, when games don't try to predict movement, that is what causes, you know, people with high ping to teleport around the map and glitch out every few seconds. So, what does all this have to do with Peeker's Advantage? Good question. Quite a lot, actually. All right. You see, when you peek an angle and someone is standing there watching it, you know, a few things are happening, right? First is that your game knows that the player is standing there before you even peek, because the server sent your game that information a while ago. However, for the player watching the angle, they have to wait for the server to receive the data from your computer, have the server process the data, and then make sure it's correct and not compromised by a cheat. Then pipe that information down through their internet access, and then wait for their computer to finish processing that information. Then have their computer display that, you know, you are actually moving around that corner. So when you peek into that other player, if either player has a bad connection, it can lead to the other player getting peeked, dying before they even have a chance to react. Did you get that? I hope you did. Okay. In extreme cases, sometimes players will even die before their game registers that the player even peeked them. Hopefully now, you know, you can see why Peeker's Advantage is a problem, man, and you know why Riot is trying hard to fix it as best as they can. Mr. Straley stated that they measure Peeker's Advantage with the following equation. It's enemy's client's frame rate, plus enemy's one-way network lag, plus server frame rate, plus your one-way network lag, plus network interp delay. And as you can see, you know, Riot has a few other things they consider other than just network lag. They also measure server and client frame rate. Okay, so some of those variables are always the same though, right? Like network interp delay and server frame rate are always 7.8, 125 ms. For the variables that are not constant, Mr. Straley also explained their impact. One-way network lag is based on game server locations, your and your opponent's, geographic locations, and Riot Direct routing paths. We are targeting 17.5 ms for 70% of the player population, as well as your client frame rate is based on how fast your computer runs. We are trying to optimize frame rate as much as we are able to on our side, as a dev team. So these words are all fine and dandy, but is there any actual evidence that Riot is actually working on these things they claim they are? Actually, yes. In patch 0.50, Riot optimized the map split a bit more to help increase frame rate while playing matches on that map. As mentioned before, Riot also created something called Riot Direct. That deserves its own video, man. But a very quick description is that Riot Direct takes the information from your ISP and makes sure that it takes the fastest route to Riot servers. Okay, so you guys gotta check out the link in the description below to watch Riot's video explaining just how their system works. Riot claims that average human reaction time is about 247 ms. No joke. Peeker's Advantage in Valorant is an average of 40 to 70 ms. But even a minor head start is still meaningful. And they would be correct. Even a minor delay between two very good players could result in an unfair death for the player being peaked, because those fractions of a second matter a lot more at high-level play. It is why so many CSGO pros refuse to play on Valve's matchmaking servers. The servers are just too slow, and peaker's advantage is just too much of a problem, you know, especially on those servers due to a lack of optimization. Strafe shooting is another network-related issue that is somewhat similar to peaker's advantage. It's likely you've come across a situation where you are killed by a player who appears to be mid-run. In actuality, man, on this server and from their point of view, they are standing still. This issue has more to do with, you know, how servers handle receiving data. I'll just let Mr. Straley explain this, all right? A network interpolation delay causes a 7.8125 ms desync between movement data and damage data. Otherwise said, you know, when you get killed, the player's move position is always shown 7.8125 ms behind from where they actually fired. This can make it appear as if the player was moving when they shot you, when they might have actually just been standing still. This is a more prevalent issue when players are using counter-strafing effectively, as the typical muscle memory is to shoot in the frames after a counter-strafe. A quick note, counter-strafing is when a player is holding a movement key. So let's just say D, for example, and they want to stop moving quickly, so they tap the A key to cancel out their momentum. So this might seem like a pretty easy problem to fix, just to remove the network delay, right? But it's really not that simple. If Riot just removes the network interpolation delay, it could cause more issues than it fixes if you don't have ultra, you know, reliable internet, including player pop in and desync. Instead, Riot seems to be working on a few other fixes, including faster animations to show a player that stopped moving faster, removing corpse blocking, which is when, you know, you die, you know, your corpse blocks the camera from seeing what your opponent was doing on the frame you died, and slightly delaying your death on your client so, you know, you can see the other player stop moving. The last idea has an unfortunate side effect of being in purgatory, as Mr. Straley put it, as on your screen you might be alive, but the server registers you're dead. Moving into the ranked portion of this Q&A, we heard from Ian Fielding, the product manager for Ranked in Valorant. Mr. Fielding discussed why Valorant allows for any party size, you know, while queuing for Ranked unlike League of Legends, where in that game there is one Ranked queue for only solo and duels and one for three stacks and above. Mr. Fielding's reasoning for keeping the party size open was, having a solo queue can easily lead to that becoming the definitive test of someone's skills and the primary way to play competitively. We've opted instead to allow players to play at any team size they prefer. We also think it's viable for players to search for good teammates now for competitive play. So when higher stakes competition becomes available, they already have teammates they can rely on. It seems like Riot is really focused on letting the competitive scene just grow naturally. And the fact that they're going as far as, you know, to promote players to find groups of people to play, you know, is pretty encouraging for the future of Valorant as an esport. You know, if you guys watched our video about the four most underrated weapons in Valorant, link in the description, by the way, you might remember our question of the day being about the ranked badges looked a bit simple, and apparently Riot was listening. A couple items high on our list in the short term are making it easier to queue with your friends during your placement matches, as well as better clarity for rank icons. Long term, you know, we're exploring adding a rank progression along with other features based on your feedback. More to come on that in future updates. Okay guys, so the last thing Riot covered in this Q&A was their anti-cheat Vanguard. As I'm sure a lot of you already know, that there have been some setbacks with Vanguard. We've heard feedback from players that it felt like Vanguard was being overbearing in its approach to security, so we're taking another approach. As of last week, Vanguard's compatibility with vulnerable software packages has been expanded, while a small number of drivers are still blocked. From now on, almost all the software that Vanguard was previously blocking will work properly on Vanguard-protected computers. It does seem like Riot is trying to take steps in the right direction to fix Vanguard, but, you know, I think the core issues still remain. You know, with Vanguard having the highest level access and being very trigger-happy with blocking things even after this most recent patch, it is clear Riot still has a long way to go before Vanguard is just running effectively. So in the meantime, if you're having problems with Vanguard, make sure to reach out to Riot's support and open a ticket. Try to be patient, you know, as I'm sure, you know, they are receiving a huge amount of support tickets right now. Unfortunately, you know, we still have not received a full update on the performance issues, mainly being, you know, FPS drops. The only thing Riot had to say about that was, we're going to skip the known issues because this whole post has been about them. We're still actively working on client FPS drops. See you next week. Hopefully next week, we'll have more of a detailed answer to the performance issues. But all we can do at this point is just sit tight and just trust Riot has it under control. All right, guys, once again, this is your motivation guy. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. Make sure to connect with me on my Insta at your motivation guy. That about wraps it up for this video. You know, what do you guys think about Riot's explanation for Peeker's advantage and the network they have in place to try and help prevent it? Remember to leave your answer to the question of the day in the comments down below, and I'll see all you guys later. Peace.